Hello everyone, my name is John. Today, I will tell you how to set up uploading leads from your Facebook advertising account to Google Sheets. This is necessary in order to automatically transfer new leads from Facebook to other systems. For example, in Google Sheets, you can add new lines to conveniently store, process and interact with them in every possible way in the future. Now let's move on to the setup. First, you need to create a new connection. Next, you need to select the Facebook data source system. Now you need to specify the action. If you want to receive new leads, select the Get Leads New action. At this stage, you need to connect your Facebook account to the ApiX-Drive service. In this window, we need to specify the username and password of the Facebook personal account. Then go to Advanced Settings. At this stage, you see the advertising pages to which you have access. The advertising pages for which you want to receive leads must be ticked. I recommend marking all advertising pages at once at this stage in order to be able to work with them in the future. If you get a new advertising page after connecting your Facebook account to ApiX-Drive, you will need to repeat the connection via incognito in the browser, and at this stage check the new advertising page. Leave all checkboxes enabled. When the connected login is displayed in the list, select it. At this stage, you need to select an advertising page and forms for which you want to receive new leads. If you want to receive leads for all advertising forms at once, leave yes, connect all current and new forms. If you want to receive leads on some specific forms, select no, select forms individually, and tick the necessary forms. At this stage, you can set up a data filter. In this case, there is no need for this, so just click continue. At this stage, you see an example of one of your leads. If there is no data at this stage or ApiX-Drive test data is displayed, you need to wait for a real lead or generate a test lead through the Facebook advertising account. After you do this, click Load Test Data from Facebook, and when the lead appears at this stage, click Next. On this, the Facebook data source setup has been successfully completed. Now you need to move on to setting up data reception. At this stage, you need to select a data receiving system. In this case, Google Sheets. Next, you need to select an action. Add row. At this stage, you need to connect your Google Sheets account to the ApiX-Drive service. In this window, you need to specify the login and password of your personal Google account. At this stage, you need to grant permission to ApiX-Drive and tick all the access checkboxes. When the connected login is displayed in the list, select it and click Continue. At this stage, you need to select the file and sheet for which new lines will be created. If you have added the name of the columns in the first line, it will be displayed in brackets opposite each of them. In these columns, you can assign variables from Facebook. In order to do this, click in the field and select a variable from the drop-down list. Note that you can use not only variables, but also set values manually. When all the required fields are filled, go down the page and click Continue. At this point, you see an example of the data that will be sent to Google Sheets as a new line for each new lead from Facebook. If something does not suit you, click Edit and go back a step. In order to check the correctness of the settings, click Send Test Data to Google Sheets. After successful submission, go to Google Sheets and check the result. If everything suits you, return to the ApiX-Drive service and continue setting up. This completes the setup for receiving Google Sheets data successfully. Now you need to enable auto-update and select the communication interval, for example, once every 5 minutes. That's all. I wish you successful integration settings and good luck.